In this video, I am going to show you how to select a subset of observations from your data set. Sometimes we need to conduct some statistical analysis with only some of the observations in our data file, or we want to create a new file that includes only the observations that meet a certain criterion, and I'm going to show you how to do that. This data file includes three variables. The first one is called student ID, and this is just a numeric identifier for each student in the data set. So when we have 38 students here, the second variable is called instruction. This is a categorical variable with two categories and shows that some students received active instruction, whereas other students received traditional instruction. So we have two categories. The third variable is a ratio variable called score change, which shows the amount by which students' scores changed after they received instruction, whether it was active or traditional instruction. Let's say that we're interested in conducting some statistical analysis with only the students who received active instruction. So we need to get rid of all the other students in the data set. One way to do this would be to just manually select all the other students and then just right-click and choose Cut, so all the other observations will be deleted. This is not a very precise method. With a small data set like this one, we may not make any errors, but it doesn't work that well when we have large data sets with hundreds or even thousands of individuals, especially if the observations in the data set are not ordered by this categorical variable. So I'm just going to click Undo to get all the observations back. Another way to do this, which is much more precise, is to let SPSS do the selection for us. And to do that, we can go to the Data menu and then select the option Select Cases. In this area, we have all of our variables that we can use for this procedure. In the right area, we can click on the if condition is satisfied to just tell SPSS how to select the cases. And if we click on the if button, in this window, we can tell SPSS the rule by which cases will be selected. And in our case, we want only the cases for which the instruction variable has the value active. So I'm going to select from my list of variables the variable instruction and then click on this arrow. In this area, we have to specify the formula or the rule for selection. So I now have my variable called instruction, and I'm going to type equal quotation mark active quotation mark. Because this is a string variable, we have to use quotation marks. If this were a numerical variable, then we didn't have to do this. So this is my rule. I want to select all the cases for which the instruction variable is equal to active. And then I click continue. In the lower part of this window, we can specify whether we want these cases to be moved to a new data set or if we want to work with the same data set and just delete all the other cases. I think it is always safer to just move the cases that we want to a new data set, so I'm going to choose the second option. And in this area, we should type the name of the new data set, and I'm going to name it active. And then click OK. Now the analysis was run. I can see here my old window, which includes all the cases. And I have a new data window now, which includes only the selected cases, only the students who received active instruction. If we look at the output window, we can see that we don't have any statistical output per se, but we do have a log here that lets us know that the analysis was completed, or the selection was completed. So this is our new data file. Notice that this data file is temporarily named active, but we still have to save it under a new name.